Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making shrimp and grits. And my inspiration behind this dish was that trip to Hanger's restaurant here in Richmond, Kentucky. Rick and I went recently and he ordered the shrimp and grits. And I looked at it, tasted of it, and got an idea of what it would be like. So this is my version of shrimp and grits as inspired by Hanger's restaurant. So I hope you enjoy it. And we'll start making the shrimp and andouille sausage part because the plate had a ring of some andouille sausage and also shrimp that was spiced up. Also had some vegetables, and then the grits were in the middle, and well, I think the shrimp were on the top. So I'll decide how I want to arrange it when I get to plating it, but I think you'll find all of the ingredients are there, maybe not in the same order, maybe not exactly the same recipe, probably not the same recipe, but it will give you a way that you can have shrimp and grits. So we're going to start with andouille sausage, and Rick and I don't want to make a whole lot of this, so I didn't use the whole pack. You can see that four of these come in a pack that is 12 ounces. So I took two of them, and I have just used a knife to cut them into coins. And we'll put them into a skillet, and that skillet is going to go over to the stove, and we're going to brown these up. And that's going to bring a lot of the juices out, and we'll use the juice in just a minute. I might tell you, meanwhile, I have some vegetables cooking. They just have to cook for a few minutes, and I put them in right before I started. These are frozen mixed vegetables. You can choose any kind of vegetables that you would like on your plate, under your grits. You could use mirepoix if you wanted that, or a different sort of mixed vegetables, or just pick a particular vegetable that you like. Now, this is what I've prepared so far. I have the coins of the andouille sausage all browned up that I did in this skillet. And what I did was to take them out and put them on paper toweling. And honestly, they're pretty dry because you see there was no liquid left, actually. If there had been some liquid left, I would have poured most of it off. Now, the vegetables that I talked about, here they are. They're crisp tender, so they're edible, but if they get a little more heat, which they will, it won't hurt them. Now the next step for me is to work with my shrimp. So I have shrimp here, which I'm not going to use anywhere near all of this. In fact, as I recall, there were only like three or four shrimp served at the top of the grits, and they were just placed in a very attractive way. I think Rick really likes shrimp more than that, so I'm going to get some of these done. And we'll put them around wherever we want to on the plate. This package is the 31 to 35 count per pound. So I'll show you the size that we're getting. That's a little bit bigger, I think, than what we had at the restaurant, but it's up to you. Now I have washed these and put them back in the bag. I mean, I rinsed them off with water and put them back in the bag. I wanted to show you the bag, but I'll pour these into a bowl just to make it easy to work with. Now what I want to do is to get these cooked, and it's very easy to cook shrimp. But when you have a little bit of oil in your skillet, you just put them in and put them on top of the stove, stir them around a little bit, and they'll turn pinkish when they're done. And you'll notice these are pinkish because what I have from my bag over here cooked. So these are cooked shrimp. You may use raw shrimp and it will cook in your skillet at this point. So I'm keeping in mind that I don't really have to worry about anything other than overcooking these. So we'll just put a few in. I think Rick would like to eat some even plain. But we have that. And I'm going to wipe my hands before I go on, so I'll be right back. What I'm going to do is add some Cajun spice or Cajun seasoning. And it's up to you in terms of how much shrimp you have put in your pot and how much how spicy you like it. Remember, we do have the andouille sausage there, which is going to be spicy. And we'll be putting it with some grits that I've already made. And actually, I've uploaded those grits, and they had a little bit of red pepper in them. So they're a little bit spicy. If you want to look them up, and I'll be using them in just a minute, so you'll see them. But they are cheddar parmesan grits. But I'm considering 1/2 tablespoon of Cajun seasoning, just putting it right on the shrimp. And if there were a little bit of juice in the bottom, I would go ahead and mix that together and heat it. But I think at this point, since there really is nothing for me to work with, I'm just gonna stir it around. I know they're cooked already. And then I'm going to put the andouille sausage with them. And I'm gonna put my vegetables with them. So this is actually going to be the base of the plate, and then we'll pick out a few shrimp to put on top. So I'll go to the stove and just stir this around a little bit over heat, and it's a very easy dish for you to make. So if you have raw shrimp at this point, all you're doing is cooking your shrimp. Just takes 3 or 4 minutes, but all we have to do is heat all of this mixture, and then we'll plate it up. We'll have a really nice plate of shrimp and grits. We're going to form our plate of shrimp and grits. So here I have everything heated together along with the Cajun seasoning. So that makes it a little spicier than it would be normally. Now, as I recall, I might be wrong on this, but it doesn't really matter. I think there were some vegetables underneath the grits. So I'm going to put a few down just right in the center of my serving plate. And right here I want to show you, this is what I have of my grits after I took some out for taking pictures and so on that previous upload. To look for this, look for cheddar parmesan grits. And then if you want to use that kind, fine. If you want to use some other kind of grits, I would advise cheese grits or some kind of flavored grits, because grits that are plain just do not have as much flavor, obviously, and maybe are not as enjoyable. But if you think that there's so much flavor in the shrimp and the andouille sausage and the vegetables, then perhaps you would like this plain. What I've done is to spray a little soup bowl here and pack in some of the grits. And I don't think it's going to be as easy to get it out as to just plop it out on the plate, but go around the edge with a knife, and hopefully putting that cooking oil spray on will help. And here we go. So you need a mound kind of like that. And then what you can do is decide whether you want to put shrimp on the bottom or not. Let's leave it just for the top. So we'll get the andouille sausage and the vegetables, and then just kind of ring around the grits. So I'm totally avoiding the shrimp, but remember, they're flavored up the same way, so they'll be nice. And trying to space out those sausages so that there won't be just a whole lot in one spot and not much in another. And vegetables as well. And I'm just making one plate up of this, although there's plenty on my mixture to go further. I think I'll go with 4 shrimp on the top. So this is hot. Just kind of hang it on the top, and then another one exactly across from it. You might want a utensil of some kind to punch that in. And it may have trouble a little bit. It may want to fall apart. But this type of grits is pretty solid. So I think you'll be safe with this particular recipe. And then over here. And then we need one more to just make it all symmetrical. Again, I'm not getting these to stick very well. So just make a little hole where they have to go down in it. And one more. Oh, my first one fell off. And that last one's going to go over here. Isn't that pretty? Still moving, but this is not alive, I assure you. That's our shrimp and grits. And I hope you enjoy it. Well, I'm ready to take a bite. I don't know where to begin. I do want to tell you that the shrimp that I had was the kind that has the shell still here, so it has to be peeled. The tail is on there, so you're going to have to just dig in and bring all of this off. And just at the corner of your plate, you can put your little stack of shells and tail. Sorry about that, kind of messy. But you can take a bite of shrimp. As far as the rest is concerned, let me get a little bit of my grits, a little bit of the andouille sausage, and a little bit of vegetable. So I'm not getting the shrimp here, but this will give me a taste. Very pleasant. And just to complement it, a little bit of shrimp, which did absorb a lot of the flavor. Tastes really good. Actually, I like it very much. I'm not a big seafood person. A lot of you know that. And if you see us eat out, Rick is the one who orders the dish that has seafood, and I'm the one that gets the chicken. But I do eat shrimp, just very occasionally, and this, I think, is the way I would choose to eat it. Hope you enjoy it.